Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about creating a sequence in Scratch. Now, I want you to think of a sequence as essentially a list of instructions that our computer program is going to run. And you'll find that your Scratch project draws upon not just one sequence, but many different sequences. So, what does one sequence look like? I think that's where we should start. Okay, so let's create a very basic sequence. Every sequence starts with, well, an event. Think of this as your trigger. So we have a number of different events to choose from. We see when green flag is clicked. Okay, so this is our on-off switch. When green flag is clicked, something's gonna happen. And that something is the instructions we give the program. So for instance, we can go ahead and grab a say block. So when green flag is clicked, the instructions say, well, say hello. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Hit the green flag, there we go. So we built a very, very basic sequence here. But I want to go ahead and open up my backpack and show you some of the more complex sequences that I've seen used in Scratch. So I'll go ahead and drop this in here. As you can see, we have a very long sequence that I took from another project that involved a three-dimensional cat. So you can see that as you learn Scratch, you'll create even more complex sequences. So let's go ahead and get rid of this because this is a little intimidating. So we'll go ahead and drop this in there. So much of Scratch is about tinkering with programs. So that means trial and error. And you'll find in Scratch that each block has a distinct shape. So we notice the event blocks are shaped almost like a hat, and that's what they're called, hat blocks. We notice that it's impossible for us to go ahead and attach something on top of an event block, which makes sense because an event block is, well, the starting block. So we can't attach them on top. But as you notice, I can snap this motion block here onto the say block, and that's because the shapes correspond. So you'll see a little white border there showing that these blocks can snap together. And likewise, as you keep experimenting, you'll notice that there are multiple different shapes. So see, we have a pointed edge, we have a rounded edge, and let's try and snap this on the bottom here. So move up, no, so no, but let's try it up here in the hello. Oh, we see it snaps in here because we see the white border. So right now, this might not mean a lot, but as you tinker with your projects, you'll notice that you can start adding blocks inside of blocks. So in the spirit of just experimenting, let's go ahead and try out some blocks and learn a little bit about the user interface here. So, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and grab a control block here, a loop. It looks pretty cool. I see it has this unique shape. So let's go ahead and try to attach some blocks here. So we see we can attach on top here, but then look, I think we can attach, yeah, we can attach inside here. So that looks pretty cool. And that is saying you'll forever run these commands. So I wonder what that looks like when we hit the green flag. okay, so our cat is running into the wall. Interesting. I want you to notice here, the green flag is still active. So this program is still running. And we see this, one, by looking at the green flag being highlighted. And two, we see this yellow border around our sequence. So that means it's still active. Well, what's cool about this is we can go ahead and just start adding blocks to this while it's running. So I think it'd be cool. Let's do a turn 15 degrees, attach that in there. Pretty awesome. And let's change the move to, let's say, 40. Okay. And let's go ahead and play sound. Meow. Will this fit in here? Yeah, we can attach that anywhere. Let's go, actually I don't like that block, so let's go ahead and delete that block. Oops, I've deleted more than I wanted to on that. So I know that got a little crazy, but that's sort of what I love about Scratch, is you know, you experiment, and if that means you have a cat that's running in a circle meowing uncontrollably, then so be it, and work off of that. But anyways, I just want to recap briefly before we end this and say, you know, keep in mind the shape of the blocks will, you know, dictate, you know, what is possible, where you actually can place a block. And that should clue you in onto, you know, what is possible when creating your project. And also that the fact that you can run your program, and be tinkering with it as it's running, can really help you in fine tuning your project and seeing that real time interaction. So I hope that was a helpful introduction, and I wish you all the best creating your first sequence in Scratch. So I hope this was a helpful introduction, and I wish you all the best in creating your sequences here in Scratch.